Which ones?
Spies Wife.
I love the Orphans as well. And Sean Paymont and Diamond Hunter, yep. And Jack Hawksworth, of course, which is...
Spider-Man, and this one.
It's a lot of books.
What's going on there?
It's like my inverted commas disclaimer. We love Fiona McIntosh. We love her.
We do.
So we're a little biased.
Well, it seems like, you know, we've read and reviewed so many of her books, you know, historical.
Plus, we got to sit down with her ever so recently to talk about the Sugar Palace. And that's what I love about her is that she, A, is prolific, a word we love to use when talking about authors, but she is a couple of books a year and they're just completely different.
How'd she do it?
Absolutely. So Sugar Palace was a beautiful novel set in Sydney, a historical fiction. This we head back to...
DCI Jack Hawksworth.
Who's now a DS.
DS, so what's the difference?
Detective Superintendent.
Oh, so because of the last book, it was dead tired, and obviously he would have got a promotion since then.
He's very talented.
This is the fifth book,
we're back to him, and I love Jack. He's a character I'm quite enamoured with.
I really...
These are my big words for you today.
I know, I don't know what she's talking about, because my vocab is not as good as Victoria's. Anyway,
you like this because it's Fiona, and it's crime,
it's sport. They're sports, and I sort of opened it up and went... Oh, Fiona's writing about sport here. I'm really, really interested.
And, you know, unsurprisingly, no matter what she does, whether she's talking about diamonds or champagne or whatever it is, or fairy floss, she is an absolute expert. And she's done it really well with this one. It is the fifth book in the Jack series. And this time it's set... Well, there's an Australian connection, as always, with Fiona, but it's set in the English Premier League with a young Aussie boy who made good.
Yeah, there's an English football player called Luca Bruni.
I'm saying Bruni, but we're going to agree to disagree on that.
Yeah, and there's a bit of a sting. He's been involved in a bit of a sting, bit of a blackmail, involved around some photos. And
it just
how
seems
do we explain
very well.
This?
It seems very real because it's the type of thing that goes on so much now because of social media, but because of the paparazzi and the way that their lives are invaded, particularly when they're superstars in the English Premier League.
Wow.
And nice guys, like he's Luca's character is a really delightful, lovely, young, wholesome man who's doing good by others. So he's kind of a prime target, but except that he doesn't really do usually much wrong at all.
No.
And so he fights back against the blackmail, and it turns out he's not the only one.
Well, that's it. You know, he has a decision whether he's going to pay up. I think the ransom number is quite a large one.
Significant.
Yeah, and or whether he's going to fight it. And what we find out a little bit later, we don't want to spoil too much, is that there's a lot of other elite athletes who are getting caught up in this sting as
well. And that's where Jack Hawksworth comes in to try and solve it. And he's needing something a little different because he's had to have a little break from the dramas that he's been involved in.
He needs a break between each book because he gets, you know, it's quite intense, these books.
Yes. So I liked it. I thought it was really interesting. I liked the descriptions around the sporting side of things and what the life is like. And that happened to you. You were, you know, clamoured by fans and...
Oh, just would not stop. Still happens to this day, you know. Mm. But...
Thankfully, you were never blackmailed.
No, I wasn't. And, like, I think the way that the English Premier League players are sort of just...
Glorified.
But there's so many people out to get them as well. So this is like a little very close to home with regards to what the English Premier League players have to go through.
Yeah.
And they've got to be very, very careful. And I think also, obviously with this, Fiona's done a bit of research with regards to, you know, elite athletes and the way that the clubs look after them don't look after
and
them
and the
as
layers
well.
And the levels, you know, of the management and so their own managements, but then through all the way down into the club and club land as well.
But,
I think it's a really interesting, like, scenario to write in because it will appeal to a really broad audience.
Well, Aussies who don't love their sport. Everyone loves their sport.
I feel like we get to know Jack Hawksworth a little bit more in this one. You can do it on its own, but it is nice if you know a bit more. Like, I felt like I was exploring that character a bit more, so I enjoyed it from that perspective. But if it's the first one you pick up, matter not, don't worry, it's just fine.
It's a really good way to start off the year reading this one, isn't it?
Yeah. So foul play. Thank you, Fiona.
Yeah, thank
see you soon.